How to Yu-Gi-Oh! Ritual Ingredients. In this video, I'm going to talk about a ritual deck and what makes a good ritual deck. Here are the ingredients to make a good ritual deck. 1. Archetype. 2. Monster Searcher. 3. Spell Searcher. 4. Generic Ritual Support. 1. Archetype. Ritual-based decks in Yu-Gi-Oh! Since the inception have always been about archetypes. The first ever ritual being based on Relinquished, even having a fusion, which was, I believe, the first fusion Yu-Gi-Oh! Ever had. Afterwards, other ritual-based archetypes include Necrods, Gishki, Blue Eyes, Red Eyes, Mize, and Ruin, with the last archetype being Incantation. Individual ritual monsters have been created since. Nothing has ever taken the spotlight as well as rituals based off of archetypes. 2. Monster Searcher. One of the things that makes a good ritual deck is a Monster Searcher. This is the card in the deck that searches the ritual monster you are going to summon. Since most ritual-based decks are archetype-based, 90% of the time you can use the archetype searcher in that deck to fill the role of a Monster Searcher for that deck if you are playing a ritual version of that deck. Here are some examples of some generic ritual monster searches. A. Manju, the 10,000 Hands. B. Senju of the 10,000 Hands. C. Prediction Princess, Crystal Beam. 4. Spiritual Whisper. 3. Spell Searcher. The other thing that makes a good ritual deck is the Spell Searcher. It's all very well searching the ritual monster, but if you can't ritual summon, then what's the point? Unless the monster is Zephyr Saber, Swordmaster of the Necrods, which is the only monster in Yu-Gi-Oh! At the moment that allows a ritual summon without the need of a ritual spell via its effect, usually you ritual summon a monster using a ritual spell. Here are some generic ritual spell searches. A. Sonic Bird. B. Prediction Princess, Arrow Sylph. 4. Generic Ritual Support. The archetype known as Incantation is a great generic ritual support, as it supports all ritual decks. Other ritual support cards include 1. Pre-Preparation of Rites. 2. Preparation of Rites. 3. Manju and Senju Monsters. 4. Jin Monsters. Not the XYZ Monsters, since they have the same spelling. Very easy to confuse. 2. Final Note. The last thing I want to say about the subject is that please take into consideration the ritual summoning mechanic is the least supported summon mechanic in the entirety of Yu-Gi-Oh's existence, with only getting support late 2018 and ending early 2019. There's not a lot of love for the ritual summon mechanic. Many ideas have been tried to support the mechanic. Unfortunately, not many have worked. The only successful archetypes to dominate the competitive scene have been Necrons and Gishki, with now Incantations giving other less known ritual archetypes a chance in the spotlight. Although there have been some exceptions to certain ritual monsters being special and gaining popularity. 1. Blue Eyes Chaos Max stands as the strongest ritual monster in the game, and second monster in Yu-Gi-Oh! At present having a double piercing effect. First monster in Yu-Gi-Oh! To have a piercing effect is the fusion monster Metal Foils for a Gal. 2. Lord of the Red. As this stands as the strongest effect ritual monster in Yu-Gi-Oh! Bar none. To date, no other ritual monster has a more devastating effect than this monster in terms of ritual monsters only.
You are now one step closer to becoming a Yu-Gi-Oh! Master. My fate is in your hands. Like and subscribe. Hate and subscribe. You could decide to not subscribe at all. The choice is yours. Goodbye.